Lord, we thank you. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hello, viewers. You are watching our Holy Ghost School program. We are still in a separation. My name is Evangelist Grace Ujo Kongwo. You are highly welcome. Thank you for having your time and thank you for watching. Oh, Jesus, we thank you. Father, we bless you for this wonderful moment. We give you glory. We pray, oh Lord, that you come and take this mic and minister to every one of us, oh God. Father, indeed, our soul is longing to hear from you. Our heart is longing to hear from you. And I believe, oh God, by this message, Jehovah, Lord, your people will hear it, and it will bring a great transformation in their life, and you alone will be glorified. Thank you for this great work you are doing in our midst in these last days in the life of your children. Oh, we give you praise. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hello, viewers. We are still in episode 4. We are still in separation. A call to separation, that is topic. Last time we treated on the call of separation in our father Noah, whom the Lord used to save our generation. And today, by the grace of God, we are moving into another person called Abraham. By the grace of God, we know Abraham, the father of faith. Bible says that God counted unto him as a righteous man. Why? Because he believed the Lord. And God called Abraham and promised him something in Genesis 12, which we're going to read. The Bible says, now the Lord said to Abraham, get out of your country, from your family, and from your father's house to a land that I will show you. I will make you a great nation. I will bless you, and I will make your name great, and you shall be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and I will curse those who curse you. And in you, all the families of the earth shall be blessed. In you, all the families of the earth shall be blessed. And at this point, we have seen something. That Abraham was promised. Abraham, who is already accepted the word of God, and he accepted the call of God. And Bible says that he gets ready, and he separated himself. Abraham's story started with the passage, with the rest of the family, the rest of their family that are living in the land of the Chaldeans. Now God wants to tell them to move and settle the land of Haran. Haran is a new land. It's a land of fertile. It's a fertile land. The Lord has already prepared for Abraham. And when God is telling Abraham to move, he never tell Abraham how the land of Haran will be. He only tell him, leave the land of the Chaldeans where you and your father is living. A land polluted. A land full of paganism. A land full of idolatry. A land where there is no God. A land that there is no sign of salvation or deliverance. And for the fact God wants to save Israel, God wants to bring a life, God wants to have a nation, God wants to build a nation that he will marry as a wife. And he separated Abraham from the land of Chaldeans and said, move, a place I will show you. And by the grace of God, Bible said at the age of 75 years, that was when Abraham separated. He received the call of God in a strange land. And he moved onto a land, unknown land, that the Lord will show him. This is a call that one has to believe. A call you need to accept. A call you need to agree with. Because it's not an easy thing to leave your family, to leave your parents, to leave your relative, to leave all your neighbors and all the people, your friends and the rest of them. To leave your prayer group, you leave everybody and you go. And Abraham did not argue on that. He accepted it. And the Lord promised that he will make Abraham a great descendant. He will make a great descendant from Abraham. That he will make a great nation from Abraham. That he will make a great people from Abraham. This is a promise. I want to tell us that is a promise. Every covenant of God goes with promise. And every call goes with the blessing. So what I understand is so cute here. It's so wonderful that Abraham accepted the call and the Lord allowed him. And he went away and he entered the land of Canaan and something unbelievable began to happen. Bible said that the promise sounded unbelievable to Abraham because his wife Sarah was childless. God doesn't look at our condition. What God looks into is your faith. When he said something, you believe it. Abraham knows that he's childless. Abraham knows that the wife cannot conceive. But Abraham believed God, hoping that indeed, if God will make a descendant from me, if God will make a new generation from me, that means God is going to remove the childless from my wife. He's going to conceive.
He's going to bear fruit. He's going to have a child. So Abraham believed God and he began to walk with God. He does not argue on that. Bible said that Abraham obeyed God without doubt and without disbelief. This is what God is calling of, a call of separation. It's a very high call. It's a call that you're not going to look at the back. It's a call you're not going to look at circumstances around. It's a call you're not going to look at your qualification. It's a call you're not going to look at the parents, the arguments, the ideas, the corrupt wisdoms of people around you. It's a call that you have to focus and listen careful and believe what God revealed to you, what God told you, and you move ahead without any argument, without disbelief. One of the two characteristics that helped Abraham, one, he believed without doubt and without disbelief. He believed without doubt. He believed God. He did not disbelieve God. And that is what makes his journey successful and easy. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Bible said Abraham took his wife and his nephew Lot, and he went towards the land that the Lord will show him. Abraham moved from Haran towards Shechem and Bethel to the land of Canaan. And when he reached here, it is not an easy thing. Circumstances begin to come. Things was not easy. Things was very difficult. But Abraham's faith on God did not allow him to shift from his faith. Things doesn't work out at the first stage when you separated. Why? God always allows things to push. God always allows you to be tested. God always allowed you to see the impossibilities that you will see, and you begin to think that God is not possible. God is not a God of possibility again. You begin to see situation that is hard. You begin to see worse situation. You begin to see rugged places. You begin to see things that is not smooth. What is going on that time is that God is testing you. God wants to know if you believed him. God wants to know if you agree with him. God wants to know possibility of you going ahead of the call he gave to you. Hallelujah. Mazinda Raboka. Thank you, Jesus. Excuse me. So Bible says that Abraham agreed to go to the land, and that the land that God will show him as out of faith. And at this point, Abraham agreed, and God also agreed to make Abraham a great nation. So two things work here. Abraham agreed with what the Lord taught him, and God agreed to do what he promised to Abraham. So two cannot work unless they agree. These two form, when Abraham agreed with what God revealed to him, with what God told him to do, at this point, God agreed to release the blessing and the promises he gave to Abraham. But something happened. I noticed in this world, I noticed in the Christian life today, I noticed in this race, a lot of people, God will reveal things to you. He reveal you bless you with the fruit of the womb. He reveal you bless you with the blessings. He reveal you bless you in different type of good things. And he wants you to believe before he will fulfill it. But many people, they don't believe it. Many people, they don't agree with God. How will God fulfill what he promised you if he doesn't agree with him? Two cannot work unless I agree. If you don't believe that that impossibility will be possible, how did you expect God to do what he promised you? Two people must agree. When you talk of cost, when you talk of separation, it's a work of agreement. It's a work of two people agreeing together. Why? Because a message will come forth. Separate my son, separate my daughter from this. Another person will say, yes, Lord, I will do that. It means that when the word of God comes to you to separate, that power of agreement will say, yes, Lord, I've agreed to separate. So when you not agree and you not make a move, it means God, I've agreed, I've made a move, I have separated. Now God will say, whoa, that my son, my daughter, I will do that which I said I would do. But why should we not separate? Why should we not agree with God? Why shouldn't we do what God said us to do? And at the same time, we are expecting God to fulfill his promises. At the same time, we are expecting God to fulfill his word. At the same time, we want God to do what he said, but we don't want to agree with him. That is where God is very quiet. That is where God keeps quiet. That is where God keeps silent. Because God is, you can't mock God. God is not a man, neither he's not a son of man that will lie. But he is God that when he speaks a word, he will surely fulfill it. God trusts himself. God is strong in his promises. He is strong in his agreement. He is strong in his covenant. but you want us to be strong too, so that two can walk. Because most times, what make God down, what make God angry, what make God feel so low, what keep God far away from us, is that he will be telling us, do this, and we don't want to do that. But if God is ready to do his work, he's ready to release his blessing, he's ready to do that which he promised us, but most times we don't want to agree with him. And at the same time, we want him to do what he promised, it doesn't work like that.
Hallelujah. In Genesis 15, Abraham became anxious about the promises of a nation which God promised him to the descendants. That is what happened to us. Most times when God promised us, at a stage, there will be a level we reach, we begin to be anxious. God will say so. God, you promised this. God, you reveal this. You begin to quote the years, the time. The Lord reveals something to you. The Lord promised something to you. Yes, he's not a liar. He said it because he knows he will do it. He said it because he knows he's not going to disappoint. He said it because he trusts himself. He's so strong. God is unshakable. He can't disappoint. He can't lie. So when he speaks it out, he has already speak it out. And when he speaks it out, believe it and watch. Know what the Bible say? Pray and watch. Bible say, watch and pray. When you are watching, you pray and you wait, and it's going to happen. When Abraham began to be anxious about the blessing, and Bible said, Abraham's faith began to fail. Why? Because his age is going up. His age is no more if he's easy. His age is now up. His age is growing. He's no more a baby. He's no more a youth. He has become an elderly person. And when you become an elderly person, your body systems, your body organs, there will be feeling a lot of funny on them. So what to think to Abraham? His faith begins to fall. It's because his age is no more earlier anymore. And what happened to Abraham? When his age begins to shake, when his faith begins to shake, Abraham wanted to help himself. Hallelujah. Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Abraham, the first thing he did, he make a move to adopt. He wanted to adopt the people that had been a slave in his hand. And God said, no, I will not use a slave as this covenant. I will use your blood, Abraham. I will use your seed. I say your seed. I want to bring a nation. I want to born a nation. I want to marry a nation. I want to bring out a nation that will be my people. I'm not going to use your slave. After that, what happened again? When Abraham remembered that he's childless, he disturbed him. He keep making a move. What shall I do? When he asked God, can I use Eliezer? God said, no, he's not Eliezer. I will give you a fruit from your blood, a fruit from your lineage, a fruit from your life that will be a descendant. All the plans of Abraham change according to Genesis 15 verse 2. But God rejected being used the slave. Something began to happen again. At a point, something happened. Their wife started, Sarah. What did Sarah say? Sarah says, I am getting old. I don't want you to be childless anymore. Can I give you my maid so that you can use her? So that she will give us a child. God has promised us, let our daughter, our daughter, let her give us a child so that you can able to be a mother and a father. And something said, and God says, no, I'm not going to use her. A separation of Abraham is just that God wants a specific nation to be born. God wants Abraham to get out of his people, to separate from everything that entangled him from the lineage, from the paganism, from the father's land, so that he will use him to bring a seed that will not be entangled anymore, a seed that is not contaminated, a seed that is pure, a seed that is holy. That is what God called Abraham. So God don't want Abraham to bring any deceit, any error, any counterfeit. God don't want Abraham to use a slave. God wants to use Abraham because he knows that Abraham have agreed with his word. He has already sanctified Abraham. With the faith Abraham believed God, with the faith Abraham had in God, God counts him as a righteous man. So that is why God wants to bring a seed from Abraham. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. We give you all the glory. This is the end of this epistle. We'll come back again. Stay tuned. God bless you.